I've worked as a professional sports coach for 10 years. Before I was a professional sports coach, I was working on playing professional sports. So for the last 13 years, I have been working towards being someone in professional sports. And one of the biggest things in professional sports is teamwork, particularly in a team sport, obviously. And we as coaches do an enormous amount on building teams, and building team environments, and building team ethoses, and building a bond amongst our players that makes them a stronger team than perhaps their ability allows them to be. And on this run, the camaraderie and the bond between the seven or eight guys that helped Tendai, I've never ever come close to creating an environment like that on one of my teams, and I certainly never ever was in an environment like that when I was playing.
I do think you did need to have a very close-knit team, the seven of us all together. I don't think you would have done it. As I said to Simon, I think that if there'd have been half a dozen runners running, some people would have dropped out, but because Tendai was running the run and we were all helping him, he would have never let us down. But I have to say, at the end of the run, there was a huge bond between everybody, and nobody specific, but everybody did their bit in the best way that they could.
One thing I will treasure from it is the almost team building. It sounds really cliche, but I really feel like all of us, from Tendai to my dad, my brothers, and you and Phil especially, really came away with the 6 month build up, and then on the day we all got tired together, we all went through grumpy stages together, we all supported each other in every little role we played, that sort of thing. And it was something I'll treasure. And I said to Phil as well that I think that we've create a bond and like a friendship between us that I don't think will be broken for hopefully ever, but maybe certainly not a long time. And I know Tendai agrees. I know he said when he went to bed on the Saturday night that he felt lonely because he wasn't with the team, and he'd been with the team for the last nearly 48 hours. And I'd agree. I think it was, and I think we should certainly all stay in touch. Not as I said just now, not necessarily try and recreate the day because that doesn't ever work, but it was something that we'll never forget as a team. And it's, Nick said something similar with his players for basketball, that he almost feels like all the team building things you try and do with a basketball team, nothing is ever done as equal what we did, and that sort of just came naturally, And I thought it was, hopefully everybody else would agree, I thought it was built friendships that will last for a very, very long time, so that's what I'll take away from it.
The sort of the camaraderie that we developed. I mean, I hardly knew yourself and Phil before we even started planning this. And I think we've all become really, really tight over the whole thing. So it's brought people together, which is always good. New friends have been made and stuff like that. And I just think the sort of the whole, it was like a lad's holiday without the drinking and the sort of clubbing and stuff like that. It was a really good sort of fantastic day. Fantastic day that I'll just remember forever.
Is that cold in the next? Side, you say? I have images in my head that legitimately give me a lump in my throat. I see, I could shut my eyes and see Phil Green running backwards down the A12, motivating Tendai to keep going. Now, this is Phil Green, who I've known Phil Green for 9 years. Phil Green did work experience with me when he was a kid, you know, and he was a quiet, unassuming kid. You know, on work experience, there was no huge amount of banter or anything like that. Very quiet, unassuming lad. You know, and I've now been through this amazing thing with Phil Green. You know, and I suddenly consider him a very close friend for what he did for my friend. You know, and yourself as well. And I feel like there's this sort of unbreakable bond between all of us that I have with my brothers anyway. But you know, it's the best thing me and my brothers have ever done together.
I just thought, probably even more so when I first saw him, I thought, well, he's, you know, he will do it. It was never, it wasn't the other way, it was always he'll do it. So, no, I don't, never thought it, never crossed my mind that he wouldn't do it.
No, never thought he wouldn't do it. He was so determined. Right from the first time he said he was going to do it, and everyone was saying, no, you won't do it, he was, yes, I am. And I just thought, yeah, he's going to do it.
No, I never doubted that he would do it, and I never, never doubted that he'd finish it.
I didn't realise how emotional the whole thing was going to be until we saw them at that first checkpoint.
We all certainly knew it was going to be very hard. I think he said to me himself, actually, when I was running one small stage with him, he said, I said, is this harder than you thought, T? And he said, no, he said, but I just didn't expect my legs to give up.
I think I was most impressed with T when we got to Colchester, really. We stopped for another massage just outside B&Q or something like that, just on the outskirts of Colchester, going into Colchester, and T had just ran, you know, 50 miles or whatever, and he sort of laid down to have his massage, and it was quite amazing, really, because his mind, his passion, his breathing was all under control. You know, I thought by that point T would be a bit of a mess, but he wasn't. And, you know, he was more in control than anything else. It was just simply that his legs were in so much pain that, you know, it was something that we hadn't planned on, really, I think, that they were saying, look, I can't, you know, you can't run anymore, you've got to start walking.
I'm keep on wondering, why am I doing this? That's the reason it's going to keep on going, you know?
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
If someone said, you want to run 3 miles for fun, no, I said, no.
Yeah, exactly.
But you're not out of breath,
too. No, 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 bread, I'm okay. Bread, I'm okay. It's only legs. So bread, all right, I don't remember. The only thing is just legs. On my knees, like, It's when you're running, okay, just doing like this. It's like needles or, you know.
For the majority of that time, you had Phil and Nick running beside him. I mean, if anything, at that point at Colchester, T was most impressive. It was simply because Phil had trained him so well, you know. Phil hadn't taken any training on to do a marathon, and with a mixture of cycling and running, I think Phil actually ended up doing more than a marathon's worth that day. He still had energy by the end of it, really.
I kind of get muddled up on sort of the distance.
Yeah.
I wasn't prepared for it. I didn't think I was going to do any sort of running or biking or anything like that. I just thought, you know, I might hop on a bike, 5 miles every 20 miles or something like that. I think I biked the first 15 with him.
Yeah.
To get out of central London. Then I sort of off the bike and started to run. I think it was split up, but I think I ran sort of 25, maybe 30 miles, but that was sort of split up with maybe, you know, 5 miles in a van here and there.
Yeah.
And then sort of from sort of, you know, just after Colchester to Ipswich, I was with him then as well.
And Nick as well. I mean, Nick hadn't done any training for it, and it felt like Nick had done the majority of the run with T, you know, and I was kind of just impressed by all three of them, really. Their passion, their commitment to support and to carry on was like nothing I'd seen before, really.
Marathon, one marathon is good. Piece of cake, you know what I mean? I'm telling you this, you know, like you, I'm not telling you, few. One marathon. This, you know, all you're talking about, now we're talking about 3 marathons. But we didn't have to manage to stop, you know what I mean? You know, we're just going, you know, the guys are cycling high, you know? And part of things, you know, if someone running slow,
yeah,
cycling is much difficult.
Yes. Not for superhumans like us.
No.
Wait.
Okay, yeah.
Hotel
Elizabeth. Yeah.
So if you wait,
hopefully. Well, you can tell her where they are.
Okay. Yeah, if they're
fast cake, wouldn't it? But I would say if he just walks up this bit and up the hill,
he's going to walk. I'll happily walk.
Right, okay, so if he walks up there and he walks up Ipswich Road until it's not an incline.
Yeah.
And then he jogs a third of it, probably. And then he jogs to Ardley, then me and Phil will take on.
So we'll
go on the slip road.
Yeah, it winds a bit. So just as if you were driving to Richardson, where you can't see the footpath, you've got to go round.
We'll indicate in the van or something like that.
Yeah.
So you're right, Rob, you want some sweets or something like that?
Yeah, no. So that's that.
Is there a mirror here?